Hello friends, welcome to my channel once again. Today we are going to discuss about engine thrust, takeoff thrust, installed thrust and finally thrust equation. Consider the above propulsive duct in which the inflow air is at pressure PA and velocity VA and leaves the exhaust nozzle with a velocity of VE. The pressure with which the air or gas leaves the exhaust nozzle is PE. The net thrust FN due to change in momentum is written as FN is equal to M dot VE minus M dot VA plus AE of PE minus PA, where M dot VE is gross momentum thrust and M dot VA is intake ram drag and AE of PE minus PA pressure thrust. The thrust relation shown in the last slide is of general nature and is valid for cases where a residual exit static pressure exists in the exhaust flow if it assumes that the expansion in the nozzle is completed to PA. And hence, a second term, pressure thrust, can be neglected. The thrust is written as Fn is equal to M dot of VE minus VA. For a net thrust Fn, the thrust power may be written as thrust power is equal to Fn minus Fn dot VA. The basic thrust equation indicates that as forward speed VA increases, it is necessary to increase either the mass flow or exit velocity VEX or both in order to hold the thrust F constant. The near constant thrust characteristics at any altitude, a desirable and attractive features of jet engines or flat rated engines. A near constant FN results in almost direct increase in the thrust horsepower with forward speed. These characteristics of turbojet engines exist well up to the high subsonic speed range and with a properly designed inlet diffuser extends into the supersonic range. In the supersonic region, afterburner equipped engines enable large increase in thrust with Mach number. This is possible from Mach number is equal to 0 to Mach number greater than 3. At high flight speeds, Mach number 1 and above, an appreciable proportion of the air compression is accomplished by inlet diffuser ram effect. In fact, at a Mach number well above 3, due to enormous ram effect, it is economical to dispense with the compressor and hence also the turbine. And this has given rise to ramjet engine. The propulsive efficiency eta p can be defined as the ratio of useful propulsive energy or thrust power, that is F dot VA, to the sum of that energy and unused kinetic energy of the jet. This is kinetic energy relative to the earth and may be written as M dot of VE minus VA square divided by 2. It then stands to reason that this unseed exit kinetic energy is a waste energy, and once it goes out of the engine body, it is not of any use for thrust production. Although inlet diffuser provides aerodynamic precompression of air, it also produces ram drag. The propulsive efficiency eta p can be written as eta p is equal to m dot va of va minus va divided by m dot of va minus va plus VE minus VA square by 2. That is simply written as 2 by 1 plus VE by VA. Eta P is known as Froude efficiency. For the above equation, it is evident that FN is maximum when VA is equal to 0, that is at takeoff, but eta P is equal to 0. Eta P is maximum when VA by VA is equal to 1, when thrust is 0. The propulsive efficiency is measure of how well the propulsive device is being used for propelling the aircraft. It is different from the efficiency of energy conversion. The efficiency of energy conversion is given as eta E is equal to m dot of VE square minus VA square by 2 divided by m dot of dot Q, where m dot F and Q F, Q fuel are the fuel mass flow and its heating value respectively. The denominator refers to the energy released by burning of fuel. The overall efficiency is given by eta O, that is equal to M dot VA of VE minus VA by M dot F Q Q.Fuel. That is, if propulsive efficiency into energy efficiency. At supersonic aircraft speeds, the ram drag is also high. Moreover, at supersonic flight speeds, it is difficult to design an air intake to efficiently handle the airflow required by the engine, which may have an afterburner for thrust enhancement. This requires matching the intake characteristics to the engine over a wide operating range of flow conditions as well as altitude. At hypersonic flight speeds, this prompts us to look at ramjet for thrust generation. Since there are no rotating components, example compressor turbine, matching the inlet to the engine is simplified. Fuel consumption of a turbojet and other jet engines is normally presented in the terms of thrust specific fuel consumption. In short, we can pronounce it as TSFC. The thrust specific fuel consumption varies with engine ram, Mach number and altitude. Generally, a minimum at the tropopause at 80-90% rated RPM. For jet engines with reheated or afterburning, the fuel consumption would be quite high, and specific fuel consumption would show up as a high value. In such operations, sheer thrust requirement outweighs the high specific fuel consumption. Turboprops have lower specific fuel consumption. This fact has prompted development of turboprop fans. Specific fuel consumption can be given as m dot f by fn, where the units are expressed in terms of kg per newton hour or mg per newton second. Actual computation of fuel mass flow and net thrust would vary from one kind of jet engine to another. Because VE is considerably greater than VA, mainly at low flying speeds, the efficiency is much lower than that attainable within a propeller. Since propeller efficiency drops off rapidly at higher Mach numbers, that is greater than 0.7, there is a speed where jet propulsive efficiency exceeds that of a propeller. Because of overall efficiency of turbojet is lower, the Mach number at which the overall efficiency of turbojet equals the overall efficiency of propeller jet engine is more than the Mach number at which their propulsive efficiencies are equal. Design point of an engine. All engine components are designed for a specific engine operating point, which is normally very close to the maximum thrust requirement from the engine. That is where the rotating components and non-rotating components are geometrically sized and shaped. Most engines meant for transport or passenger aircraft are designed very close to the takeoff requirements. Some military aircraft engines are designed to meet thrust at supersonic flight conditions. Off design point of an engine. All the engine operating points other than the design point are known as the off-design operating points. At all these operating points, all components of the engine must work together in a matched manner as an unit to produce thrust. The aircraft on which the engine is mounted must also work within this thrust envelope. Thus, before an engine is mounted on an aircraft, a very elaborate aircraft engine analysis procedure is normally carried out. With this, we'll be closing this session. Thank you. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe.